As I recently said in another video, Uranus represents a sort of neglected planet. It lacks moons with clear evidence of liquid water like Saturn and Jupiter have, and yet also generally lacks the pizzazz of Neptune with its storms and the cryovolcanoes of Triton. In fact, we've only been to this planet once with Voyager 2, and indeed it wasn't even discovered until 1781. But one aspect I've always liked about the Uranus system are the names of the moons, which were not chosen from Greek mythology, but literature. That naming scheme may have turned out to be prophetic. Uranus, despite its rather sordid name and generally lackluster appearance, actually hosts a dynamic system sporting at least 27 moons and a set of rings, albeit faint ones. But unlike most planets in the solar system, Uranus is seemingly in for a profound change in the number of moons it has. The reason for this is that at least two pairs of moons in that system are on a collision course. One collision, speaking in terms of geologic time, is imminent. In a paper by Robert Chancia and colleagues linked below, they actually set out to study the behavior of Uranus's Eta ring. The shape wasn't quite what it was supposed to be, but they were able to calculate the gravitational interactions between the tiny moon Cressida and its interactions with the other moons. They realized that Cressida would eventually collide with another moon, most likely Desdemona, within the next million years. Worse, if it's still around in some form, it's also possible that Desdemona could collide with the moon Juliet within 100 million years. The next two moons slated for collision of some type, they may just bump into each other and go on their way, are Cupid and Belinda. The time frame here is a bit less certain, sometime within the next 10 million years, though it could be a lot sooner. With a chance that the new moon that might form from the debris might eventually collide with the moon Perdita. These moons are small, and they're in such a position because their orbits are very tight, and this may not be the first of such collisions, but instead part of a cycle. There is some evidence that Uranus's outermost ring might have resulted from these kinds of collisions. I would say that this whole state of affairs is almost poetic. Uranus's moons were named after characters in Shakespeare's plays and other works of English literature. That the small ones periodically kill each other evokes Hamlet in some strange way. But Uranus is not alone in having misbehaving moons. There is another moon in this solar system that is likely to undergo collision, but in this case, not with another moon, but its own planet. Worse, it's the main planet we want to colonize. It's Mars's moon Phobos, and it too has a fitting name. In Greek mythology, the god Phobos, often depicted as a warhorse of Mars, personifies fear, and in fact the word phobia derives from this, and there is much to fear. This suicidal moon gets closer to Mars by 2 meters every 100 years, and sometime within the next 30 to 50 million years it will either collide with Mars or break up and form a ring system around the planet. Either is likely to affect a human colony on the surface, which if we haven't colonized it by then, we probably went extinct. If we have colonized, we very likely would move Phobos to a higher orbit, or disassemble it completely to build orbital structures. But I offer another scenario. Say we went extinct after we terraformed Mars, and life on that planet was running wild, or even on the brink of extinction itself by that time, as I'm not certain how long an untended terraformed Mars could hold its environment together. But might the death of Phobos be the last nail in the coffin for human-induced life on Mars? Thanks for listening, I'm futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently thanking all of you. This channel has really taken off the last few months, which is a humbling experience to be sure, and I couldn't have done it without your support. I continue to have more fun doing this than any human should be allowed to have, and do expect many more years of content, and perhaps even centuries if this transhumanism thing pans out, or more, thousands of years of JMG content. On that note, be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.